Oh, now it is on. There you go. Today, a couple of things are happening. It's the third Sunday in Advent, and as you all know and remember, it is Gaudet Sunday, and as you all know, that is Latin for rejoice. Rejoice is the first word in the Latin version of Mary's Magnificat in Luke chapter 1. Therefore, that's our psalm for the day, the Magnificat, and we are going to sing it. So when we get to that point, you'll see the Magnificat in the bulletin as a song. It is Marty Haugen's version of the Magnificat as found in his Holden Evening Prayer. So we're going to talk about joy in rejoicing. We're also having a baptism. So we begin with our gathering hymn, My Lord, What a Morning. Please rise. Zane and his family to come forward. God, who is rich in mercy and love, gives us a new life into a living hope through the sacrament of baptism. By water and the word, God delivers us from sin and death and raises us to new life in Jesus Christ. We are united with all the baptized in the one body of Christ, anointed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and joined in God's mission for the life of the world. Danny and Dawn, called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace and love of God, do you desire to have Zane Gutierrez baptized into Christ?
I do.
As you bring Zane to receive the gift of baptism, you are entrusted with responsibilities to live with him among God's faithful people, to bring him to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, teach him the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments, place in his hands the Holy Scriptures, and nurture him in faith and prayer so that he may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, care for others in the world God made, and work for justice and peace. Do you promise to help Zane grow in the Christian faith and life? Dr. Robert and Jane Berg, do you promise to nurture Zane in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Spirit and to help him live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the church?
I do.
People of God, do you promise to support Zane and pray for him in his new life in Christ?
We do.
I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God?
I renounce them.
And now to everyone. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into heaven. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. Right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
The congregation may be seated. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood you delivered Noah and his family, and through the sea you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river your Son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you set us free from the power of sin and death, and raises up to live in you. Pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of your living word, that those who are washed, that Zane, who was washed in the waters of baptism, may be given new life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. All right, Zane. Can I lift you up? Zane Gutierrez, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now stay with me. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit you give our daughters and sons new birth, cleanse them from sin, and raise them to eternal life. Sustain Zane with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the Spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. Zane, child of God, you are sealed with the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ forever. Amen. And now let's see if I can lift you up, Zane.
Zane, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven. Do you want to hold this?
And to everyone, let us welcome Zane.
We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word in all the world.
Congregation, please rise. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Share God's peace by greeting those around you. Go ahead, you can blow it out. Very good. God's peace. God's peace. God's peace. God's peace. Yeah. For a little bit.
For a little bit. Walk around and talk to people.
And we continue with the candlelighting song. The choir will not sing it through once. We will sing it. Joy is a celebration given by God through the light of the world.
Joy is a celebration given by God at the birth of the Christ child.
Joy is a celebration when the angels sang, "Glory to God in the highest."
Let us dance and sing and shout for joy. Christ is coming again.
Let us pray. Source of light. Shine in our lives and in your world with your life-giving joy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Stir up your hearts, Lord God, to prepare the way of your only Son. By his coming, nurture our growth as people of repentance and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from Isaiah, beginning with verse 35. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom like crocus. It shall blossom abundantly and rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord and the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are of fearful heart, be strong and do not fear. Here is your God. He will come with vengeance, with terrible recompense. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless shall sing for joy. For water shall break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. The burning sand shall become a pool, and the thirsty ground springs of water. The haunt of jackals shall become a swamp. The grass shall become weeds with rushes. A highway shall be there, and it shall be called the Holy Way. The unclean shall not travel on it, but it shall be for God's people. No traveler, not even fool, shall go astray. No lion shall be there, nor shall any ravenous beast come up on it. They shall not be found there, but the redeemed shall walk there, and the ransom of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the book of James. Be patient, therefore, beloved, until the coming of the Lord. The farmer waits for the precious crop from the earth. Be patient with it until it receives the early and late rains. You also must be patient. Strengthen your hearts, for the coming of the Lord is near. Beloved, do not grumble against one another, so that you may not be judged. See, the judge is standing at the doors. As an example of suffering and patience, beloved, take the prophets who spoke in the name of the Lord, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 11th chapter. When John heard in prison that what the Messiah was doing, he sent word by his disciples and said to him, "Are you the one who is to come, or are we to wait for another?" Jesus answered them, "Go and tell John what you hear and see. The blind receive their sight, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, and the poor have good news brought to them. And blessed is anyone who takes no offense at me." As they went away, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about John. "What did you go out into the wilderness to look at? A reed shaken by the wind? What then did you go out to see? Someone dressed in soft robes? Look, those who wear soft robes are in royal palaces. What then did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom it is written, 'See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way before you.' Truly, I tell you, among those born of women, no one has arisen greater than John the Baptist. Yet the least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. I'd like to invite the young people to come forward. Good morning. We're getting a few more. We need a lot of help this morning. Come on, Zane, you can help us. The theme today is joy, okay? So we're going to sing a song. Repeat after me. Joy, joy, joy. That's what it's all about.
That's what it's all about.
'Cause God loves us, we love each other.
'Cause God loves us, we love each other.
Mother, father, sister, brother.
Mother, father, sister, brother.
Everybody sing and shout. 'Cause that's what it's all about.
'Cause that's what it's all about.
It's about joy, joy, joy.
It's about joy, joy, joy.
And then you keep going and going and going. So what is it about? Joy, 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 joy. Well, you know what? It's about love. It's about hope. It's about peace, but today, it's about joy. All right? God wants us to be his joyful people. Even when things are gloomy, he wants us to be his joyful people. Isn't that something? And why can we be joyful? Because we know God is always with us. We know that was a promise made to Zane today, that God will always be with him. Let us pray. Repeat after me. Gracious God.
Gracious God.
We thank you for joy.
We thank you for joy.
Your joy.
Your joy.
Deep in our hearts.
Deep in our hearts.
In Jesus' name we pray.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
All right, you can go back to your seats. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. The name of my sermon is Joy, Rejoice, and Be Glad. Let me begin with a story about David Wilson. David was a pretty ordinary Lutheran. didn't do much at church, always did what his wife told him to do. Things like, you be an usher. So he was an usher. And one Advent Sunday, his wife came to him and said, David, you are going to buy a Christmas present for Anna. Anna was a little girl in Mrs. Wilson's class who did not, whose family did not have the means to buy her a gift. Her father was ill. Her mother ran a home cleaning business and didn't really make enough money to cover everything. And of course, David's going, why me? Why should I buy a gift? And she said, David, buy a gift. And he goes, how much should I spend? Whereupon she said, don't be a cheapskate. So he decided $20 would buy a nice gift. And he's complaining to Charlie, who happens to be an usher with him that day. And Charlie says, hey, I'll go in on that with you. And David says, all right, when do you want to go shopping? And they brought Anna along. And Anna gets in the car, and they said, well, where do you want to go? And Anna says, to Walgreens. And David goes, no, no, Anna, Walmart. You'll get a much better deal at Walmart. No. It says there's a better selection of toys there. She said, Walgreens. So they go to Walgreens. This little girl, 9 years old, David and Charlie following her to the back of the store to a display. And there's all kinds of things to help people who are sick at home. And she points to a cane, one of those canes that has four prongs on the bottom. And she says, that's what I want. And David and Charlie are going, no, no, you don't want that. Yes, yes, that's what I want. They get it down. She brings it up to the cashier. And the cashier says, $39.95. She put her $20 down, two $10 bills. Is this enough? She said, no, you're short. You're short $19.95. David's going, you don't have enough money. Charlie's going, oh no. She turns around and starts crying. So David gets out another $20 bill and puts it down. They drive home, somewhat in silence, and then David complains to Charlie, this trip cost me $40 and we didn't even get a toy. And then Charlie reminded him, no, I gave you 10. Okay, it cost me $30. Didn't think much of it. And we'll get to the rest of the story, because David is about to realize joy. Karl Barth said, joy is a very strong theme in Scripture. And Karl Barth said it this way, it is astonishing how many references there are in the Old and New Testaments to delight, joy, bliss, exaltation, merrymaking, and rejoicing, and how emphatically these are demanded from the book of Psalms to the epistle to the Philippians. Over a hundred admonitions to be joyful and rejoice in the Psalms alone. The Bible, we could even say, is harping at us to be joyful. In your heart, rejoice. Oh no, another law to follow. Now I've got to be happy, right? It's like a few years ago, I was at a Christian meeting in town, and they had a Christian comedian, and he says, he doesn't like it when people say, have a good day. Oh, wow, now I'm burdened with having to have a good day. Thanks. Often, we don't want to see Jesus laughing. Believe it or not, when I show a picture of Jesus laughing, I get more complaints than any other picture of Jesus. He's not supposed to laugh, is he? So why? Why don't we? Sometimes it's too many disappointments happen to us. Everything from the childish Dennis the Menace, notice the living room was strewn with toys, and he says, is this all? At Christmas. How many have been there? Is this all? So too many disappointments. Sometimes life is disappointing. God, you're not giving me what I want. Yet God says to us, rejoice and be glad. We're told, of course, admonished to take up your cross, deny yourself, seek the blessedness of the poverty of the spirit. How can that be joyful? Ted says, the church has been waiting for over 2,000 years. That's a long time. Rick says, Jesus created people who wait and serve. Ted, are you saying that like it's a good thing? We're to wait and to serve. And for that reason, very often we've taken discipleship to the point of being, we have to be serious about it, and it sort of robs us of joy. It's no mistake that one of the number one best-selling nonfiction books of all time was The Purpose-Driven Life by Rick Warren. We all want to have purpose. We all want to have our lives driven. But being driven often takes away the joy. And the other thing that may rob us of joy is the state of the planet. The United Nations recently set out a memorandum, the United Nations Food and Agricultural Division. The refugee crisis is only worsening, they say. Nuclear threats grow in the Middle East and with North Korea. Human trafficking is expanding. Billions are mired not just in poverty of material needs, but also poverty in spirit. So, who in the right mind would talk about joy? Empathy, maybe, but joy? I don't know. Then we have Isaiah 35. The first 39 chapters of Isaiah were written by first Isaiah, and we don't know whether or not he ever saw the return of the people from Babylon, the people of Israel in exile from Babylon back to Jerusalem. But there was glimmers of hope. Cyrus was king, and Cyrus was the king that was now going to return God's people. Isaiah foresees the day when they will return, and he talks not merely of a day when they'll return to the desert, which is Israel, or this semi-arid place, but it's going to be a blooming desert. It's going to be a time of rejoicing. Even the ground will rejoice. In this short passage, he mentions rejoicing. The crocuses and the blooms and the desert will rejoice. And he mentions joy four times. The people will return, God's people, and rejoice and be glad. And as I say, they don't know if they ever did return. And when they did return, we know that it wasn't to a blooming desert valley. It was to a destroyed Jerusalem and just rubble. But Isaiah says, rejoice and be glad. Now, why should they rejoice and be glad? The good news in this text is that you can rejoice, you can be glad, you can have joy in your heart because God is with you. God has not abandoned you. God is working out God's purposes in God's people. Rejoice and be glad. In the Brothers Karamazov, Leo Tolstoy had the priest in that novel say something that was surprising. He talked about, the priest was talking about the first miracle that was ever performed according to the Gospel of John, and that was turning water into wine. And the priest said this, "Ah, that miracle. Ah, that sweet miracle. It was not humanity's grief, but its joy Christ visited. He worked his first miracle to help humanity's gladness." G.K. Chesterton put it this way, "A person is fully human when joy is the fundamental thing in him or her, and grief the superficial. Melancholy should be an innocent interlude, a tender and fugitive frame of mind. Praise should be the permanent pulsation of the soul. Pessimism is at best an emotional half-holiday. Joy is the uproarious labor by which all things live. Joy is the uproarious labor by which all things live." Well, let's get back to David Wilson. The Sunday after Christmas, David Wilson is doing what he normally does on Sunday afternoon, watching football. And of course, he hears a knock on the door, and he's rather annoyed that somebody is disrupting his football game. Opens the door, and there's a man holding a cane, holding himself up with the cane at his door. And he recognizes him as Anna's father. He asked if he could come in. David invited him in, and they sat in the living room. The man was out of breath, and he said, "I just wanted to come by and say, you're one heck of a guy. You are one heck of a guy." He said, "Let me tell you." See, up to this point, David thought he was a drunk. That's why he never mowed his lawn. That's why he seldom cleaned the snow off his driveway. And he said, "When I was young, I had a fever, and it damaged my heart. And when I was young, they replaced a valve in my heart. And he said, I should have gone to the doctor more often. But when my heart really started getting bad, when I went, they said it had affected my organs, so I was no longer a candidate for surgery. My doctor told me that I might not make it to next Christmas. So I have avoided buying a cane so I can even get out of the house. You are one heck of a guy. Thank you. And then he got up and he left. And David just sat there, stunned. He was stunned because he realized in his curmudgeonly way, we could even say an anti-God way, God still worked through him in his life. David Wilson found joy. The good news today, if you need hope, you can find it here. If you need peace, you can find it here. If you need joy, you can find it here. Amen.
Thank you.
As we anticipate the fullness of the presence of Christ, we join with the church throughout the world, praying for all who are in need. God of reversals and new life, we praise and thank you for the joyful vision that you gave your ancient prophet Isaiah.
Nature reveals your glory and sings for joy whenever you restore it with new, abundant life. Help us as your redeemed people joyfully sing our way through lives of service. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Jesus, our coming Messiah, we, like John, at times struggle with doubts and are tempted to look in the wrong places to wait for someone other than you.
Forgive us, set us straight, and remind us of your saving work whenever the blind see, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, and the deaf hear, and the dead are raised, and the poor have good news brought to them. May we be as we prepare to celebrate your coming. May we be joyful, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of Israel and the Gentile nations, grant wisdom and grace to President Obama and President-elect Trump and the leaders of all nations, that they may govern with justice and work for peace.
Raise up, God of peace, leaders who work for the protection of all. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God, our healer, we pray for the fearful and sorrowful and for the sick.
We remember especially Jeannie Burnell Graves, Carolyn Callan, Michelle Farley, Mary Lou Fisher, Lou Graves, Doug Hobine, Robin Kennedy, Vera Kimsey, Jack Myers, Chris Marquardt, Wayne Myers, Bill Payne, Jim Raisins, Pat Roper, Pat Shikaney, Lucy Stilwell, Bonnie Turner, Rod West, and Marietta Young. Are there any others?
Help us to always be your joyful and thankful people.
Today we thank you for Zane as we welcome him as a worker in your kingdom, and for all our children as we prepare for the Christmas program.
And we pray for the departed who were faithful to God's word.
We remember especially Ellen Kamens. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Merciful God, hear the prayers of your people, those spoken aloud and those known only to you, and grant us peace through Jesus Christ, our coming Savior. Amen.
us pray. Savior of the nations, come.
Make your home here in us. Feed us with your love, that our faith shine ever new, and our lives renew your light. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ. You comforted your people with the promise of the Redeemer, through whom you will also make all things new in the day when he comes to judge the world in righteousness. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. The night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Let me remind you that the second Sunday in the month, we commune via intinction, where you'll receive a wafer, the bread in your hand, hold on to it until the chalice comes by and dip or intinct it into the wine. Our Lord invites us. All is ready. Please come. You may be seated.
Thank you.
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Amen.
Oh,
God, for whom we wait, you come to us in the broken bread and the cup we share. Make us ready always to welcome Christ into our hearts and send us forth to be your people in the world, announcing your coming among us in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
I'm going to encourage you to read your messenger, and don't forget, someone's going to make an announcement about tonight.
Good morning. I have an excellent opportunity for you all to find some joy in your lives by joining us at the Children's Christmas program this afternoon. It'll start at 4. We're going to start the prelude at 4 and have some kids share some piano and vocal and instrumental solos, and then we'll follow with a program probably about 4:20-ish or so. But we'd love to have all of you there to come see the kids and how hard they worked. So thanks.
Thank you. Excuse me. David.
Good morning. I'm David Sick, and I'm the Dave Ramsey Financial Peace University coordinator. If you look in your messenger, you'll see there's some very good information about the course. One thing to remember is December 27th is the deadline we have for sign-up, so we're able to order materials so we have them available for the class. We hope that you will read this, think about it, and participate. It is something that's changed countless people's lives, and it can change yours.
Yes, thank you, David. In fact, a number of us who took it found it extremely helpful. And that was 13 weeks. Now it's down to 9. Receive this benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
Guided by the gospel, we welcome all to worship, make disciples, hunger for ministry, nurture you. Go in peace, remember the poor. Thanks be to God.